worship you. I worship you. I worship.
Tell your neighbor the bad day.
Gamba mulirana wo lunaku olubi.
Tell them the bad day.
Mugambe nti olunaku olubi.
Tell another one the bad day.
Gamba nomulala nti olunaku olubi.
Has he understood that?
Akitegedde.
Ezekiel chapter 4.
Omubulize sule yokuna.
My interpreter is interpreting from KJV. Two are better than one because they have a good return in their work.
Nti babiri basinga omu kubanga baba n'empeere nnungi olw'okutegana kwabwe.
Amen.
Amina.
We are in the season of fellowship.
Tuli mu biro ebya fellowship.
Which we are crowning up on next Sunday.
Ye tugenda okumaliriza Sunday ja.
On Independence Day. That they were expecting all lineages to put on their uniforms. We are going to have a Holy Communion service.
As
the Bible tells us that whenever they gathered together, they broke bread. So we are going to do that next Sunday. So we are in the season of understanding the importance of fellowship.
Fellowship.
Now the Bible said two are better than one.
Bible yegambye nti ababiri bakira omu.
That is period.
Chikomao.
So if the Bible said two are better than one,
Bible wegamba nti nababiri bakira omu.
It means then one is worse.
Chitegeza nti omu atabeda bubi nnyo.
If two are better,
yobanga ababiri basinga.
If you are only alone, then you are worse.
Wobanga oli bwomu weka kiba kibi.
So the Bible teaches us that they have a good return for their work. Meaning that whatever you do and you want to do it alone, you will never have a good return for your work. Being selfish will take you nowhere. So the Bible says two are better than one. Because they have a good return for their work. So meaning if they are more than two, then it becomes more better. And then verse 10 says, if one falls down, his friend can help him up. But pity the man who falls and has no one to help him up.
Nti kubanga bwe bagwa omwali musa munne na yezi musanzo yali yekabwagwa songa talina munnamu yimusa.
Amen.
Amina.
So the Bible said that if you are two and one falls down, the other will help his friend up.
Bible yagambye nti nemu babiri omu nagwa omu ajja yimusa munne.
But pity a man who is alone and then he falls down, there will be no one to help them up. So the Bible here puts it clear that anyone standing is the right candidate for a fall. If you are standing, the Bible say you are a right candidate to fall. Whether you
are
standing walking, whether you are standing in your marriage, whether you are standing at your place of work, whether you are standing in your ministry, the Bible say you are the right candidate for a fall. But the Bible say pity if you are alone and you fall, because no one will help you up. As you are walking, there is a day when you are going to fall. There is a day for a stumble. There is a day when you are going to fall. There is a bad day. In this life, there is an evil day. In this life, there is a day of trouble. It doesn't matter whether you are so beautiful, whether you are so rich, whether you are so anointed, whether you are so great. You are still in this life, there is an evil day coming. Amen.
Amina.
Turn to your neighbor and say the bad day. Psalms 50 and verse 15.
Zaburi atano lunyira kuminatano.
It says, and call upon me on the day of trouble. I will deliver you and you will honor me.
Ntero nkowo olenga kulunaku olokulabe naku. Ndikuwonya na olingulumiza nze.
So God is saying there is a day of trouble.
Katonda gamba nti waliwo olunaku olwennaku.
And when that day comes,
ntero lunaku olwelujja.
God is saying call upon me.
Katonda gamba onkowo olenga.
If God say there is a day of trouble,
Katonda wabagamba nti waliwo olunaku olokulabe naku.
Who are you to say there is no any day of trouble?
Gwani okugamba nti teluli iyo.
Ephesians chapter 6.
Abefeso mkaga.
And verse 13.
Olunyira kuminasatu.
If you are there, you say amen.
Wobotu sayo gamanti amina.
I'm waiting for the amen. To know that you are there. Therefore, put on the full armor of God, so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground, and after you have done everything, to stand.
Abefeso mukaga kumi na satu. Egamba, ntikale mutwalenge byokulwanisa byonna ebya Katonda, mulyoke muyizenga okuguma ku lunaku olubi, era bwe mulimala okukola byonna, musobole okuyimirira.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the Bible says, put on the full armor of God. So that when the evil day comes, you may be able to stand. And after you have done everything, you stand your ground. So, even in the New Testament, the Bible says that there is an evil day. And that day, when it finds you, when you have not put on the full armor of God, then it's going to turn you and leave you apart. And
you
say that after you have done everything, you may be able to stand. When that evil day comes, praise the name of the Lord. It is very dangerous to move alone. It's very dangerous to remain alone. The Baganda have got a saying that anyone who walks alone, it's the birds that will tell that you are dead.
Enzige?
Abaganda bagamba sebo isi womu msegaze zibika. Vultures will announce your death.
Ensegaze zibika.
Because you are moving alone, once you fall sick and you fell and you die, and no one will know that you died, and the vultures will move around to enjoy your flesh, and then people will know someone has died there.
Ntikubango tambula bwomu ne wona rali de yo ne wona fide yabante bajja kumanya naye ensega eziita zezijjo kumanya nti ofudde.
They will come to feast on you, and then the people will see the vultures around and they will know there is something wrong.
Zijja kujawolize yagalenga zizo
So that's why the preacher say it's very pity for a man who is alone. But two are better than one. They have a good return for their work. Praise the Lord. So Psalms have said that call on me upon me on the day of your trouble. And Apostle Paul said that when the evil day comes, put on the full armor of God. So meaning every bad day you have your bad day. There is a day of trouble. There is a day of falling down. There is an evil day. It's like you wake up on a wrong side of the bed. You woke up and you don't understand the day. Whatever you do messes up. You hold the glasses, they got broken. You move, you just fall down. You move, you knock everything. And you wonder what happens. That is the bad day which you didn't plan. You slept well. You woke up. Things are not on your side. Maybe you have been even praying and fasting. When the bad day comes, doesn't care whether you have been praying or fasting, it is a bad day. When the evil day comes, doesn't want to know how your status is, it is an evil day. There is one day I woke up. I went in my car. I began driving. I was so shocked. I was about to knock a tree. I said, I'm very careful when I'm driving. How comes I was about to knock this tree? Where was I looking? Okay, I went on. Few meters, I've gone. The boda came just instantly. He was about to knock me. I said, what is happening? I was driving down Nawe Road. Two kids instantly crossed the boda road. Then I said, something must be wrong. This day is not right. So I parked behind.
But
and I was alone. There was no one to talk to me. So I prayed alone. I continued with my journey.
As
I was about to branch here, another vehicle instantly came in. I was about to knock. So I parked the car there. I said, for 2 days I'm not going to drive. Because things were not on my side. You can wake up and when things are not on your side, that is a bad day. You wake up, all the debtors, they begin to call you. As if they had a meeting. This one calls you my money, another one calls you my money, another calls my dress. Say, what is happening? Everyone now is, everything is against you. That is a bad day that confuses your understanding. You find yourself, you are just only making losses. You give excessive balance. They give you 10,000, you give them 15,000
balance.
I mean, everything is a mess. That is a bad day. Praise the Lord. There is a day when you go in the machine to check your blood and they say things are not right. That is a bad day. Because the world comes upside down. You begin to move as if you don't know where you are going. That is a bad day. Doesn't matter whether you are so rich, whether you are so beautiful, whether you are so anointed, that is a bad thing. There is a day when bad news comes and they say you have lost a loved one. The Bible says in Psalms that blessed are the man who trusts in the Lord, he will not be afraid of bad news, meaning bad news are there.
And
they come, they say, someone has gone. You don't believe it, but it has happened. The media people has it, breaking news. So you are waiting for, these are breaking news. They break the heart, they break the mind, they break the emotion, they break everything because they are breaking news. So that day comes when you receive bad news. Praise the Lord. There is a day when you are pregnant, you're expecting a child. You go in the machine and they tell you are carrying a dead child. That is a bad day. Bad day happens. The preacher says that pity a man who is alone. When the bad day comes, he has no one to help him up. There is a time when I was planning for a mission in Rakai and bad news came to me, breaking news. You have lost your daughter. That was a bad day. I don't know how I went to Rakai because I went after Barrio, but I don't know how I was moving. I don't even remember what happens, but I was driving. You can find people moving on the street and you think they are sober, but when they are moving in their bad days. I don't even remember the message, the season, what we preach about, because I don't remember. I was in the bad season. Bad day comes. Tell your neighbor, bad day comes. But woe unto a man who is alone. When a bad day comes, they have no one to lift them up. You wake up and breaking news comes. Your job, your place of work, fire has caught it and it is all down. That is a breaking news. I was watching on the news and someone has bought like a 5,000 chicken and he was driving his pickup to go and buy chicken food. As he was coming back, the fire has destroyed all the birds.
That
is a bad day. That is an evil day. There is a day when you fall into a sin and say, how in the world did I fall into this? That is a bad day. That is an evil season. The Bible says those days happen. John chapter 16 and verse 32. If you are there, you say amen. Are you there?
Otuseo.
Jesus said, but a time is coming and has come when you will be scattered, each in his own home. You will leave me all alone. Yes, I am not alone, for my Father is with me.
Yes, unabadamu. Labe kisera kijja era kituuse mwe munasasanira buli muntu mu bibye munandeka nzenzeka so sinzeka kubanga kitanga ali wamu nange.
Jesus is saying there is a time is coming to scatter you.
Yesu agambye nti no waliwo olunaku lujja olw'okubasaasaanya.
The time is coming.
Ekisera kijja.
The time has come. Some of you already you are in your bad days. You are passing through your bad season. And Jesus said, others, the bad day is coming. So the time is coming and the time has come. So in other words, he was saying the time is coming for some of you and some of you the time has already come. You are going to be scattered. Your mind gets scattered. Your concentration scatters. Your mind is scattered. You are not together because your bad days has come. And verse 33. I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world, you will have trouble, but take heart. I have overcome the world.
Ntebyo mbibabulide mubene mirembe munze munsi muline naku na yemugume nze mpangu densi.
So Jesus is confessing to the disciples.
Yesu ayogereri abayigirizwa.
Some of you misread this scripture.
Abamukumwe tawandika bachino mujisoma bubi.
And you say in this world there are so many troubles.
Logamba nti munsi muno mulimwe naku nyingi.
No, Jesus said in this world you will have trouble.
Ku Yesu agambye nti munsi muno mulina enaku.
You disciples, you will have trouble. The world is okay, but you will have trouble. So in this world, you will have trouble. So if Jesus said you will have trouble, trouble will come. There is a bad day, there is an evil day, there is a dangerous day, there is a day of fall, there is a day of trouble. But Jesus is saying, but take heart. Because for me, I have overcome.
Wali walu naku olubi, olunaku oloku labe naku. Na ye Yesu agami antino mwe mugume kubaga nze mpangu de.
The preacher says,
omubuli zagamba.
Woe to him who is alone.
Nchizimu sanzo yaliye ka.
When the bad day comes,
kubanga olunaku olubi weluja.
He has no one to lift him up.
Taina wakumuyi musa.
Praise the Lord.
Mukama yebazibu.
Matthew chapter 26.
Matayi abiri mumukaga.
And verse 37. You can read up to 41.
Matayo abiri mumukaga.
37 to 41.
Asatu mumusanvu. Natwala Petero n'abaana ba Zebidaayo bombi. Natanula okunakuwala n'okweraliikirira ennyo. Awo n'abagamba nti omwoyo gwange guliko ennaku nnyingi. Zigenda kunzita. Mubeere wano mutunule nange. Natambulako katono navunama nasaba nagamba nti ayi kitange ekikompe kino kinveeko oba kiyinzika naye singa nze bwenjagala wabulanga gwe bwoyagala nadde eri abayigirizwa n'abasanga nga beebase nagamba Petero nti kazi temuyinzizza kutunula nange n'essaawa emu.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. This is Jesus,
Ono Yesu,
the Son of the Most High God,
Omwana wa Katonda wa
Mani, who is God Himself,
Ngateye Katonda Mwene,
the man who moved doing miracles,
Omusajja yatambula ngakole bya
mazuru, raising the dead,
Ngazukiza bafu,
doing wonders,
Ngakole bya wunyisa,
feeding the hungry,
Ngawonya anga
feeding
abayala.
And everyone was saying, our man, when he was coming in Jerusalem, people were shouting, Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he who comes the name of the Lord. Everyone was saying, our man, he was enjoying his good days, but his bad day came. If a bad day can come to the Son of God, what about you? And Jesus, when the bad day came, he was wasting away inside and said, what can I do? I'm dying inside. Whom can I talk to? I need some fellowship. I need some people to stand with me. So he went to Peter and John and James, the sons of
Zebedee.
He brought them apart. They went on the mountain and said, look here, my friend. My soul is heavy. It's full of sorrow. They're about to kill me.
The person speaking these words was Jesus. He said, I'm full of sorrow and it is killing me. I feel it is killing me. I don't know whether it is in your Bible. You may think it's mine. Check your Bible.
Yesu yabyogera.
It is Jesus saying this
one. Nagamba mpulire naku.
That I'm so sorrowful.
Zinzijudde ku mutima.
It is so.
Zagala na kunzita.
And it wants to kill me.
Banange mwemireko nange.
Please stand with me.
Musabeko nange.
Pray with me.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is the Son of God.
Ono mwana wa Katonda.
Who knows everything.
Amanyi buli kimu.
All powerful.
Nga ina amanyi manji.
Knowing everything.
Amanyi buli kimu.
But his bad day came. And he needed some people to talk to. He wanted to pour out his heart and say, help me. Stand with me. Pray with me. And they began to pray. And when he came back, he found them sleeping and said, friends, can't you even tarry with me for 1 hour? Let me tell you, fellowship leaders, people in fellowships, these 3 months, we are going to experience miracles, signs and wonders. But this is the thing we are going to do. When people come, when they are in their bad days, and they pour out their prayer requests, don't sleep. Don't say we'll talk about it. Don't say we'll pray for you at home. That is the only time this person is passing the bad days, he needs your prayer. Immediately they begin to pray. Praise the Lord. So Jesus said, why are you sleeping? This is the time I need your prayer. He was son of God. I thought he was son of God. He was so powerful. He was king of kings. He was a superhero. Do you also have sorrows? Bad days. They don't care whether you are so anointed, whether you are so powerful, they will always happen. But when they happen, Jesus said that pray with me, tie up with me, share with me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. If it happened to Jesus, it can happen to anyone. When you are passing in your bad days, some of you could be now, you are passing in your bad season. Everything is against you. You lose a job. You come back home. The wife is also mad.
You
say, what is happening? I have just lost my job. I came back to tell my wife. My wife is also mad. What is now going on? You come to church. You sit in the chair. The ushers say, leave this chair, go somewhere else. So what is happening? You go in the toilet. You find someone there and say, you are destroying our water. And you say, where am I going to go in this world? Bad days happen. Acts chapter 12, verse 1 to 4. You can read.
Mubire byo kabaka Kerode n'agolola emikono okukola obubi abamu ab'omu kanisa n'atta n'ekitala Yakobo muganda wa Yokaana. Awo bwe yalabanga Abayudaaya bakisiimye ne yeeyongera okukwata ne Peetero z'ennaku ez'emigaati egitazimbulukuswa. Bwe yamala okumukwata n'amussa mu kkomera n'amuwayo eri abasirikale 16 okumukuuma kinnabana, ng'ayagala okumutwala mu maaso g'abantu okuyitako nga kuwedde.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Mukama yebazibwe.
Amen.
Petero.
Peter.
Omusajja w'amaanyi.
A mighty man.
Musajja yatambula ne Yesu.
A man who traveled with Jesus.
Yesu yamuwa obunnabbi.
Jesus gave him a prophecy.
Yesu n'amuwa ebisuubizo.
He gave him promises.
N'agamba oli Peter.
He told him, you're Peter.
Era ku lwazi kuno.
And upon this rock,
ngenda okuzimba ekkanisa yange.
I'll build my church.
N'emisinja egy'emagombe.
And even the foundations of hell will not be able to shake it.
Ekyo Peter ng'akirina.
Peter had that.
N'amugamba, laba nkuwa ebisumuluzo.
And he said, see, I give you
the keys.
Whatsoever you lose
will
be losing.
Na buli kyosiba,
and whatever you bind,
jina asibwa,
will be bound.
Peter,
Peter had all that.
Byonanga abimanyi.
He knew all that.
Na yake ndo kwesanga.
And he found himself.
Peter, ino kusiba ebintu.
Peter, who had to bind beings was bound. He was bound by the Romans. A Roman prison. They bind you and they take away all your clothing. You don't put on clothing. They don't have clothes for prison. They leave you in your underwear. And they bind you in chains. Peter who had scriptures. Peter who had Jesus. Peter who moved with Jesus. Peter who knew it all. The Bible says that he used to move and his own shadow could heal the sick. One day he made a crusade. He preached the gospel and 30,000 men got saved. Peter the mighty man who has to loosen is now bound in chains.
The bad day had come. Verse 5.
Awo Petero nakumiwa mukomera na yawe kanisa ne banyikira okumusabira eri Katonda.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Kubira Yesu mungaleze kitiwa.
Clap for Jesus.
Petero yayiga akakodio.
Peter knew one
akakodio
tactic.
Nagamba nti Yesu bwe yali ali mu ndaku ennyingi.
He said that when Jesus was in so much sorrow,
yatuyita tusabeko wamu naye.
He called us to pray with him.
Era Bible egamba mu Luka.
The Bible says in Luke,
nti Yesu bwe yali akyasaba,
that when Jesus was still praying,
ndaku emujjudde,
when he was full of sorrow,
malaika wa Mukama nakka,
the angel of the Lord came down,
malaika wa Mukama namugumya,
the angel of the Lord strengthened him.
Ekifo we yali nekyaka kyonna.
And the place was all shining. And he told him, have heart. I'm with you. Whatever you go through, God knows it all. And then Jesus said, now let us go. So Peter knew that in one way or the other, information was passed to some people. He said, I'm bound now, but my fellowship pray for me. There is a time when you can't even pray. You know all the scriptures. And whatever they are telling you, you've heard it and there is nothing new. God loves you. I know that. What you bind on earth will be bound. I already know that. You don't want anyone to speak with you. You just need people to stand and pray for you truthfully. Ecclesiastes has said that pity a man who is alone, for when the bad day comes, he has no one to stand with him, and you find such people killing themselves. Verse 6. Tikulunaku Kerode yali ayagala okumutwalayo. Mukirekyo Petero yalinga yebase wakati w'abasirikale babiri, ng'asibiddwa n'enjegere bbiri, abakuumi bali ku luggi nga bakuuma ekkomera. Laba malayika wa Mukama
n'agaloka. Mukama yebazibwe.
Amen.
Mukama yebazibwe.
Praise God.
Petero baamukwata.
Peter was imprisoned.
N'agamba ate ntasaaki.
He said, now what else?
Obabasabe.
Let them pray if they are to pray. But let me die. He said, I want to die in a good way. Let me sleep. And I wake up in heaven. God take me in my dream. Because what had killed Jacob, James had come for him. What had killed his friend James had come for Peter. The bad day that killed James had also come to Peter. So Peter was struggling with this bad day that James had already surfaced. He said, let me sleep. I wake up in the morning when I'm in heaven, seeing angels, and I will leave this
life.
There is a day when you quit, when you need some people to stand for your sake. You are done. But other people are saying you can still make it. You say, I can't do this.
But
there are others saying you can do it. You've quit and you're sleeping. You need people who won't sleep. Praise God.
Verse 7.
Tilaba malaika wa Mukama nayimirira wali okutangala ne kujula ekisenge nakuba Petero ku mbirizi namuzukusanga agamba nti yimuka mangu enjegere ne ziva ku mikono gye ne zigwa. Malaika namugamba nti wesibe oyambale engatto zo, nakola bwatyo. Namugamba nti yambale ekyambalo kyo ongoberere. Nafuluma namugoberera, so teyamanyanga bya mazima malaika byakoze, naye yalowooza nti alabye kwolesebwa. Bwe bayita ku bakuumi abasookerwako n'abookubiri ne batuuka ku luggi olw'ekyuma oluyitibwako okutuuka mu kibuga ne lubagulirwako lwokka. Ne bafuluma ne bayita mu kkubo limu, amangu ago malayika n'amuleka.
Mukama yeebazibwe.
Amen.
Mukama yeebazibwe.
Praise the Lord.
Petero ng'amanyi ali mu kukkiriza kwe Mukama azzeemu essaala ye afe.
Peter thought he was in his faith. God had answered his prayer and he's dying.
Jukira nti bwe baali basaba ne Yesu.
When they were praying with Jesus,
malaika wa Mukama najje wa Yesu.
The angel of the Lord came to Jesus.
Kati ne fellowship bwe yali esaba.
So when the fellowship was
malaika
praying,
wa Mukama najje wa Petero.
The angel of the Lord came to Peter.
Waliwo malaika ajanga waliwo abasaba ye najja kukyalira gwali mu kizibu.
There is an angel who comes whenever your brothers are praying to visit you.
Na ye Petero yenga alowooza ali mu kwolesebwa.
But Peter thought it was a vision.
Yagamba ndoze gulifaana bweriti.
He thought maybe this is how heaven
looks
like. Because doors were opening by themselves. The light of the angel was with him. He thought it was a vision. Amen. I pray that these remaining 3 months, that there are miracles you get and it will be as though you're dreaming. There are certain things that will pop up in your life and you question whether you're the one.
That corporate prayer, buli muntu alete prayer request ye tujikwate. Katonda anaba akolera ono, nate namwe nabasabye nga ina kyabakolera.
Fellowships, in this time we should pray for each other and encourage each other. As God will be working for the person with a prayer request, God will be working for all of us.
Bw'osoba nokka wansi Bible egamba nti Petero nga tabitegeera.
When you read down, the Bible says that Peter didn't know what was going on.
Ate n'abaali basaba.
But even those who were praying,
Petero bw'yajja ku mulyango nabo tebakkiriza.
When Peter knocked at the door, they didn't believe.
Bano baali beetaaga ekyamagero kya Peter.
These people needed a miracle of Peter.
Peter yeetaaga ekyamagero ky'okuva mu kkomera.
Peter needed a miracle of getting out of prison.
Mukama n'amunula mu ngeri ya kyamagero.
God saved him in a miraculous way.
Na bano ne bamuwulira ku mulyango mu ngeri ya kyamagero.
And these people saw him at the door in a miraculous way.
Bano tebakkiriza nti ye Petero.
They didn't believe it was Peter.
Nga ne Petero bw'atakkiriza nti ava mu kkomera.
Just like Peter. I didn't believe that he was living.
Katonda agenda kola ebyamanyi mulamubwo nga tomanyi tokkiriza nti nekigenda mu maaso kibi oba kituufu.
God is going to do mighty things in your life and you won't believe it.
Somo 11.
Verses 11. Petero bwe yeddamu n'agamba nti kaakano ntegedde mazima nga Mukama waffe atumye malayika n'anzijayo mu mukono gwa Kerode ne mu kusuubira kwonna okw'eggwanga ly'Abayudaaya.
Amen. Now I know the Lord has sent his angel.
There is something God will do and you say now I know that this is God's hand. Now I understand. Praise God. Praise God. You were in your bad days. In that bad God sends you. You need the people from Israel to sit with you.
Moses,
you need people from Moses to pray with you. You need people in David to sit with you.
Esther,
fellowship. You need people in Esther who will be praying with you in fellowship. What you are letting go, you should hand it over to someone else. What you say you can't handle anymore, someone else can handle. Praise the Lord. Let me give you this testimony as I'm finishing. 10 years plus ago, I was called to go to Britain to minister. I had never traveled. They sent me all the invitations and I went to the embassy. I had faith as huge as a tank. And I knew that I was going to get my visa. When I reached, I was denied a chance. I was told that my documents weren't enough. I went and gathered more. I took the documents. They looked at them and they said, still they are lacking. I went and searched for more. And now I knew that I had all of them. I went back. They said, now this is satisfying, but you won't go. Because your invitation is already lapsing. I don't know what happened next. I came with faith full, so full, and I went back when it was just under my feet. I reached home, but I don't know
how.
I just laid on my bed, but I just woke up with my shoes on. Praise God. Those who had invited me called me. They asked me what is going on. I told them I quit. I give up now. They said, no, pastor, you have to come. I told them they have denied me the visa. They did other things. They said, we're going to pray. We are going to pray for you. You must come.
I said, pray.
But me, I can't pray for it anymore.
Because
if you can mention any kind of prayer, I had prayed and I was so full of faith. I even fasted. But all my prayers and fasting was put a waste and they said that you're not going, so I quit. I had given up. But there are people who held that
week.
They kept on praying, telling me to go back. I said, okay, if you say so, let me go back. I wasn't going back because I still wanted it, because I'd given up, but because some people had told me to go back. We lined up. As we were moving towards, when there were just four people for me to enter, they said, now we are ending here today. I said, you see, I even quit before, but these people are clinging to me. How come there are just four people remaining and they said we stop in here? I said, I quit for good. I went back home and slept. Praise the Lord. As I was sleeping, they called. They said, what's the news? I told them I didn't go in. And I told them, please leave me, I'll come another time. They said, no, you didn't see the consular. Just go very early in the morning. I woke up at 3 a.m. I walked and went to the embassy. I thought I was the first there. By the time I reached, I was number 120.
I said,
now these people should
leave me. If yesterday
they just took 80 and I didn't enter, how about when I'm number
120?
How would I enter? There are some people who hadn't been invited in yesterday, so I saw them struggling to join the line. I said, this is where I have to be. I also started fighting amidst them. Then a policeman came and he said that if you don't make a proper line, I'll cancel out this day. I went back. Then when he went, other people
still
went back. And I also went back forward. Then two more soldiers came. They said, you people, if you don't line up well, we're going to do something we've never done. I went back. In my 120
position.
But there were so many people behind me. And they had
good.
That's why I just went back. People went in front again. I told my neighbor at the back, I'm coming back to my
house.
Then I went in front again.
Twenyiga.
We started fighting, struggling again. Then another policeman came. He had a gun and he was of a higher
rank.
He stood. And he said, you people, I'm going to do something I've never done. I said, now why the trouble? I even quit these things long time ago. But they were on my neck. I don't want to be beaten because of a visa. Whether they're going to fire, let them do it. Let me go at the back and rest. By the time I went at the back, to look where I was, the person wasn't there. When I went, he also went in front. I told those people that I was lining up here. They said, go at the back. And when I went at the back, I was number
170.
I pocketed and I said, now what come may? He said, I'm counting three, but people refuse to be
counted.
I said, there they are, do what you want. I've given up. Whether you want to fire them, I don't know. This is the truth that I'm telling you. I said, I'm used to that kind of sound. He said, I'm three. If you don't make clear cues, I'm going to do something I've never done. I said, my
heart never say.
I was like Peter sleeping. But there were people praying. But even though you looked for an inch of a prayer for a visa, I didn't have it. I said,
one.
He said, one. I said,
number two.
Two.
When he said two,
three more people came behind me. I said, after all, I'm not the last. There are some three people behind
Nagamba
me.
Three.
He said, Satu.
Everyone about turn, the line begins from behind.
Nagamba, line
kila mabega. I
turned.
And
I was number four. I didn't understand. It was as though I was dreaming.
Petero.
I was like Peter.
God
can do something and you be as though you're dreaming. He said, go through the back door. I started walking. And I saw a huge line
coming.
And I said, Lord, you're glorious. 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 you were worthy.
I entered
inside.
And I was number 4
on the counter.
Mukama yebazibwe.
Praise the Lord.
Omuntu yomwe yangoba.
The very person who chased me
nangamba kwetoli funa visa wa.
And told me you want to get
ebintu
a visa.
Bimala.
Your things are not enough.
Yomugwe nasanga wo.
Is the very person I
na
found.
Nakwata passport yange.
And she got my passport.
Nangamba okay ogenda Bungereza.
And she said you're going to Britain.
Nagamba kale koma usawa munano chime visa yo.
Come back at 2 for your visa.
Neva yonga sibitegera.
I left and I didn't understand things.
Neva ankubire sim.
They called me.
Bigenze bitya.
That how has it gone?
Konze
I said I don't know it yet. I think it is still a vision. God will do something and you'll be as though you're dreaming. Praise the Lord. When I came back, the lady gave me my
book
and told me to come to
passport.
I got my passport and I went to the toilet. I didn't want to do anything, but I wanted to see what was in the book. And I was granted a visa. I knelt inside the toilet. And I said, Lord, be glorified. It was as though I was dreaming. I had given up already. But people were praying for me. They were saying, you must come. Whatsoever you've given up on, when you're in your bad day, you need people to celebrate us. Who said we shall pray for you? Who said you'll go on? If that man leaves you, there are people who will be telling you their name. They'll pray with you. He is the Lord who works even at the last hour. I worship.